rise to your feet as the Rogers Dabs Performance Parts Crate Racing USA Dirt Late Model Series gets ready to salute you. Race fans, they come from five different states to show you what makes them great. Those modern-day gladiators of those fire-breathing, ground-pounding, 400-horsepower rocket ships. This is America's leader in racing, the Rogers Dabs Performance Parts Crate Racing USA Dirt Late Model Series 4-Wide. Race number 14 of the 2024 campaign getting ready to come to life as we hunt for the next winner of the 2024 season. Last night, Corey Hetchcock finished off making it four wins in a row. Some statistic numbers that just stand out. 735 days since somebody else other than Corey Hetchcock won a Crate Racing USA series event here at Talladega. America's leader in racing is ready to honor a NASCAR Hall of Famer. It's the Rhett Farber Tribute, night two, We Are Green. Hitchcock's gonna show the way into turn one, and looks like on the front straightaway, there is, trouble in the back straightaway, contact with Josh Ray, Jake Rainey, trouble. And we got cars come flying into the infield pit area. And we have stacked them up on the back straightaway. Mario Gresham is involved. And man, what a hard lick on the back straightaway out of turn number two. Track officials going out to check on all the drivers to make sure everybody is okay. Man, Mario Gresham, the 21 car, the right rear looks like it is completely missing off of the 21. Jake Rainey's got some serious damage as well. As there you see the right rear tire of Mario Gresham setting just to the right side of that 21 machine. Prior to getting that first lap in the books. So points implications for Mario as he climbs out of the race car. Jake Rainey, last night's runner-up, sitting there in the 87. He'll take his helmet off as well. And there you get a good look. The HuntTheFront.tv camera crew giving us a great look at the right side of Mario Gresham's race car. Shout out to the entire team. Logan Gibson, John Shields, Jesse Porter, Potter, Scott McAllister, Richard Ford, Mr. Flipper, Tristan Porter, all in the production crew helping make this weekend happen as first responders are coming out onto the racetrack right now. So carnage ensues on the back straightaway coming off of turn number two. Ty Giles, man, the 10 car rolls right on the front straightaway here. He's got some serious right front damage, all kinds of sheet metal damage on the right side. Crew's going to get a chance to at least go around and look at all four corners of the 10 car while emergency personnel work to check out Josh Ray over in the 77. On the back straightaway, we'll await to get the official word, make sure he is okay. As there you see him sorting out the right side of the 10 of Ty Giles. Giles had a really good night going in night one. Unfortunately, that came to an end early. He rolled off 15th tonight. All this had to ensue somewhere around the 15th, 16th spot because everybody from there on back kind of got a piece of it. Looked like Matt Henderson's going to roll away. So a multi-car incident, no laps complete. That means we'll line them back up. We'll sort out who's left. But man, oh man, just as that points battle, here's the HuntTheFront.tv replay. So the 44 come off of two. It's got Jake Rainey. Looked like Rainey might have got into the brakes. Man, look at the 77 array go airborne right onto the almost the left side or the driver's side, passenger side of the 10 of Ty Giles. Man, that was a hard lick for Mario Gresham too. As it tore the left front. Check out Austin Franklin and Jackson Bishop 360. And there is the piece of debris That's on the back straightaway. So that was laying there before we ever come to turn number two. And Josh Ray right there, he's along for the ride. Watch Mario Gresham. Bam. He just comes right into the left front of Jake Rainey. Going to try to put 60 laps on the board. 6,000 on the line. We'll try it again into the VP Racing Lubricant. Smooth and clean starting box. Let's try it one more time. Corey Hitchcock, Randy Weaver bring us to green. Nose to tail are the top two. Then you got two wide. Jimmy Thomas, Tyler Millwood's going to go way up the racetrack, touch the concrete, come back down. He'll take the fourth spot. Matt Dooley will fall in line. Everybody else will filter through. Lap number one off of turn number four. Will it be Corey Hitchcock? It will be. He'll show the way. Matt Dooley puts the challenge on Tyler Millwood. That is fourth and fifth. Millwood will take that fourth spot back. Dooley will fall in line just right behind points leader Jimmy Thomas. They're in that 22. Jimmy Thomas seen the damage to the Mario Gresham car. So he knows right now he's going to try to keep building on those points, but Matt Dooley's following in tow, and already Corey Hitchcock is starting to build this thing. 2.63 last time. We'll see what it is this time at the stripe. 3.036, so a 3-second advantage. If you remember last night, it was a 6-second advantage coming to the checkers. Lee Burdett right now in that machine, cruising around in the 18th spot. On the verge of getting into the grasp of Corey Hitchcock. Just two cars between him and Corey. Now make it one as Corey's going to jump to the outside of Austin Franklin. But don't look now. Here comes Randy Weaver. Remember I told you the only thing that slowed Corey Hitchcock down last night was the tail end of the field? Well, hello, we got ourselves a battle for the lead with 45 to go. Randy Weaver and the crew may have went the wrong way last night in the setup. They admitted that. Said they'd be ready to go tonight. Well, right now, Randy Weaver following in tow. That almost what was a 4-second advantage is cut down to 1 second as Hitchcock dives down into turn three. There you see Weaver, and the rest of the field will come through with Jimmy Thomas riding in that third spot. Last time out, won this year's Alabama State Championship. Now Hayden Cardwell driving the BMF cars for Corey Hitchcock. That's some storylines as these two continue to try and duke it out as Randy Weaver trying to run him down. 22 laps to go. 0.543 last time by. Third place, Jimmy Thomas kind of lingering, trying to get around Austin Franklin as we'll sort back through the field. There's the 44, Cody Haskins. Right behind him, the 2008 series champion, Chip Brendel. That would be a battle for 10th and 11th. So the back of the top 10 right in front of them, Matt Henderson running 9th. As Corey once again trying to stay out in front of the 17 as we close in on, well, we are officially now 20 to go, coming to 19. As a matter of fact, you go back to that Hunt the Front Super Dirt Series super late model race, it was the tail end of the field that kind of maybe cost him a chance to win in that one. Right now he's trying to do it again, but this time he's leading the race, trying to hold off Randy Weavers. They'll come out of turn four, single digits, 9 laps to go at Talladega. Randy Weaver, a 5-time series winner. 22 career wins after last night for Corey Hitchcock. 735 days since the last time somebody other than Corey won a feature here. Off of turn number four, they'll go. Corey Hitchcock will see the way. 3 laps to go here at the Hornets' Nest. As you see the field sorting through. Randy got within a half a car length that time in turn one, but it will be the popsicle sticks. 2 laps to go off of turn number four. Corey Hitchcock, the East Tennessee, the Loudoun, Tennessee driver, has got some pressure. Here comes Randy Weaver off of turn number two. He'll peek to the inside, can't make it stick. Off of turn four they go. Weaver's there, white flags in the air. What final time around the Talladega short track? Weaver to the bottom. Hitchcock will try to hold off the charge off of turn number two. Down the back straightaway one more time. Hitchcock into turns three and four. Make it 5 straight. Corey Hitchcock will dominate once again at the Hornets' Nest. He wins the Red Farmer Tribute. Randy Weaver second. Jimmy Thomas third. Matt Dooley fourth. And Tyler Millwood will round out your top 5.